We recently renovated and expanded our hemodialysis center, which now has 21 machine capacity. And in conjunction with the launch of this center, we are also celebrating several important anniversaries and landmark achievements here at Prince Court Medical Center. We started our hemodialysis program in 2009, that's about 11 years ago. We were dialyzing about 1,000 patients a month, and with the increased capacity with this new center, we should be able to double the number of dialysis performed per month. One of the unique features of our dialysis here is the exclusive use of patient beds. We do our dialysis only on bed, and patients find it more comfortable. It's also safer for the patients in the event of any procedures that are needed. It's easier and safer to do for the patients. There's a few other features that I'd like to highlight. One of them is single-use dialysis, whether it's low flux or high flux. This is safer for the patient, no risk of infection associated with the reuse. Dialysis quality is also better. With each new dialyzer, we provide better dialysis. We then moved on to haemodiafiltration, which is again relatively unique in Prince Court. We are one of the few private centers that offer haemodiafiltration, which is HDF. In HDF, it's particularly suitable for patients with heart failure, patients with low blood pressure, or patients who need additional dialysis, and about 40% of our patients on dialysis use HDF as their modality for dialysis. We then moved on to launching our nocturnal hemodialysis program. Nocturnal hemodialysis is particularly suitable for patients who are working. They come at night, get themselves on dialysis, and they sleep during dialysis. In the morning, after an 8-hour dialysis and 8 hours sleep, they then get changed and go to work. So that minimizes work disruption. Nocturnal hemodialysis is also particularly suitable for patients who need the additional hours of dialysis for better dialysis adequacy. As with most tertiary hospitals, we also offer acute dialysis in the intensive care unit settings. These patients are very ill with low blood pressure, and their dialysis dosing has to be very low but continuous. So we offer 24 hours of dialysis in the form of CVVH, otherwise known as continuous veno-venous hemofiltration. And as the patient improves, we then move on to SLED, S-L-E-D, which is slow, long, extended dialysis. And when they continue to improve, then they can be moved to an outpatient center to do the standard hemodialysis. In patients with end-stage kidney failure, they can have one of the three options of treatment. The first is hemodialysis, which is also the most popular option. The second is peritoneal dialysis, which makes use of the membrane in the stomach. The third, and what is recognized as the best option, is a kidney transplant. This offers better quality of life and better survival compared to hemodialysis or peritoneal dialysis.